As your presence, so arise. Yes, Lord. Good morning. We bless the name of Jehovah. The presence of the Lord is strong. Good morning. God bless you. Rise up. Have you got your tools ready for this morning? Let me see if you remember. Have you got your tools ready? Yes, Lord. In Jesus' name. Have you got your tools ready?
Keep you ready.
Yes, Lord. Bidele Basia. Have you got your tools ready? Yes. Oh, yes, Lord. Some of you are getting it. I love that. I'm excited. That means the message is getting through. Billy Le Basia. Ha! Yes, Lord. As we worship. Yes, Lord. Let's bless his name. In Jesus' name. Listen. You know, yesterday when we prayed, there were two attacks that happened to me personally. I had two major attacks yesterday. You know, after we finished prayer, I was going out. You know, my wife was driving, and you know, the police in Ghana, there's something else. You know, I could see that this particular person was trying to push me, you know, but it's so funny that I didn't fall for it, and I ended up blessing him. That was the first thing. You know, I told you this, that listen to me, get ready for attacks, okay? When you're going through attacks, it don't mean you should stop what you're doing. Do you understand? When you're going through attacks, it's a sign that there's something that you're doing right. Are you hearing me? It's a sign. You've hit something, and there has got to be retaliation. You following me, Sister Farah? There's got to be a retaliation. You know, when you're doing something right, something or somebody has to come against you, Sister Michelle, Elder Pat. Listen, if you don't have that, then it's obvious that you're not really affecting nobody. You know, and the second thing that happened was, you know, I'm very transparent, right? You know, there's somebody, I think Dr. Donna, you know, who supports the ministry, and they decided to, you know, stop supporting the ministry. And, you know, when where I come from, you know, if I'm paying for, like, if I'm giving something, right, like, you know, I'm sowing into ministry or whatever, and I feel like I don't want to do it no more, right, all I do is I cancel. On my side, I cancel. We call it direct debit. I cancel it, right? So they can't take no money out of my account, you know. So there's this person, you know, I'm like, listen, you know, first of all the messages that we get from PayPal, you know, it's saying that, you know, the payment has been skipped. You know, you've canceled it. So payment didn't get no money from you, you know, and they kept going on. And I said, listen, I said, you know, because a while back, I called a person. I said, listen, all the money that you've ever sown into Prayer Mantle, I'm going to gather all of it and give it back to you. And that's what we did. I told you, listen to me. One thing about me, listen. Listen, you can't buy me, definitely not with money. So Dr. Dana, we gathered all the money that she's ever sown into Prayer Mantle, and we gave it back to her. I said, God bless you, go about your business, you know, God bless you. That's what I do. You see what I'm saying? I called her, I said, listen, I don't do that. You know, we're family. I have these meetings with you all the time. I gave her back her money. So yesterday she called me, Elder Pat, and I said, hey, listen, you know, I'm reading messages there from PayPal. I said, listen, PayPal is saying that, you know, it's been canceled. Sister Mary has taken a screenshot of the message, you know, to say your payment has been canceled. You know, it's been canceled. I said, trust me. Listen, Adam, listen to me. See, this is what is giving men of God, women of God, people in ministry, saved people, a bad name. We're not getting the money side right. We're lying to people. You see what I'm saying? We're telling people to do things that God hasn't said just for the benefit of your pocket. I don't play that game. Don't play that game. I told you. You know, there's somebody in prayer, mantle, you know, myself and Lady Anne. You know, we've come together to pay for her, you know, her deposit for her to get an apartment. She's going to be moving next week. From prayer mantle, the donation that you give, I took some of it and I came together. You remember I told you there's somebody in Orlando having problems with her accommodation. Well, you know, Lady Anne contacted me. We came together and we were paying for her, you know, her deposit so that she can, you know, so that she can move next week. You see what I'm saying? So, you know, can move next year. Listen to me. You know, there has to be an honesty. This thing that we're doing. You know, Jesus Christ was the embodiment of all that we do. You see what I'm saying? You're not coming in for your personal gain. You know, God uses you as a vessel to be a blessing to people. And God will reward, you know, the fact that, you know, listen, you know, the fact that you're following, you know, his, you know, listen, the same people who were spitting at Jesus. You know, it's the same people that when he went to hang on the cross. Do you know that? Do you know that? They were the same people that said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. The same people. Listen to me. If you follow prayer mantle, three things you're going to leave prayer mantle with. A rag, Bible, and water. If anybody asks you, why? It's because we pray. And listen to me, when you are in a position of prayer, you know, sometimes you might be coughing. You don't want to run to the, you know, to the fridge. The water is right there because sometimes the enemy wants to make you lose focus. You see what I'm saying? So you have the water there. You have the rag there. You have the Bible there. When the devil comes, you beat the devil with that Bible. When the sweat comes, you wipe it with your rag. When the thirst comes, you drink some water. Don't you like that? So listen to me. Because, you know, just before I came on, the electricity went out. So the noise that you can hear is the generator, okay? So I can't go to the room that I normally go to and keep, you know, and keep my phone, you know. So I may not be able to clap this morning. But please, you don't stop clapping, okay? Clap for me. Because, you know, I have to hold my phone. Okay? I have to hold my phone. So, you know, the noise outside, I can't go to the room that I normally pray in because, you know, the generator is right next to the, you know, it's right next to the window. Okay? So do me a favor. Clap for me this morning, okay? But listen to me. This morning, we're praying for the sick, the vulnerable, those who've been abused, those who've been abused from the pulpit, those, somebody said a peppermint. Well, if you're by yourself, you're okay. If you're by yourself, you're okay. You know, but listen. You know, we're praying for the sick. We're praying for those who've been hurt, those who've been abused. You know, some of us have been through those kind of things. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes, if you're not careful, those things can hinder you. You know, those things. Listen, I've learned to use those things. It's almost like I've learned to use it, you know, to climb. See, I've used those things which has happened to me in the negative as a stepping stone. You see what I'm saying? You know, I told you this. If you come from a family where you've been laughed at and mocked, it is simply because you're supposed to be the breadwinner of that family. Look at Brother Joseph. Okay? When you come from a family and you know you haven't done anything wrong, okay? But, you know, you've been castigated. You know, they've looked down on you. They've mocked you. They laughed at you. It is simply because you are supposed to be the breadwinner of that family. And because the enemy can see that there is something unique about you, what is now? See, now, because you have walked away from your responsibility, what is now? God cannot make you, what is now, the warehouse for the blessing. Listen to me, those of you who are still holding things inside of you that, you know, mommy did to you, daddy did to you, you know, listen, Dr. Dana, you need to be emailing me these kind of, you need to email me so that we can shout about these things. My God, you know, some of you don't know what Dr. Dana has been going through. You see what I'm saying? So listen to me, you have to understand, okay, that if you are not in position, what just now, you eliminate yourself from connecting to the blesser. Because listen to me, the God will give you, because listen, there are people praying, hear me, there are people praying, and listen to me, God has agents on this earth that he is going to use to be the answer to the prayers of people. That's you and I. Okay? But if we are not in position, some of us, listen to me, you are called to be millionaires. Oh, may I say why? Do you understand? We're called to be, not because, listen to me, God wants us to be walking around and, you know, listen, you have to understand that what God is going to give you, listen, the blood that was running through Jesus Christ, my God, I just received this. I just broke something because I received a testimony. Listen, the blood of Jesus, listen to me, it did not only belong to Jesus, it belonged to mankind. That is why the blood could not stay in his veins. Listen, he had to release that which, listen, that was, listen, that which was running in his veins, what is now, it could not stay in his veins. So listen to this. Do you see how God allowed situations to develop in order for the blood of Jesus to leave his veins? Because listen to me, as long as the blood stayed in his veins, listen, you had to have access to him in order to tap into the blood, like the woman with the issue of the blood. See, but the blood had to touch the whole of humanity. And since the whole of humanity could not get access to Jesus because he had disciples who would not allow people to get close to him, God said, listen to me, I'm going to allow situations to develop. My God, if you ever hear anybody talk about this thing, know that they stole it from prayer mantle. Know that they stole it from prayer mantle. If you hear anybody talking about this thing like this, listen to me. So, listen, God had to agitate some people, Sister One. You know, he had to agitate some people, watch this now, so that they can pierce Jesus. And when they pierced him, watch this now, and the blood mixed with the earth, the dust of this earth, listen to me, watch this now, it washed, it cleansed, and it sanctified everybody. Okay. Now I know why the enemy was trying, was attacking me yesterday. Listen, get your water, get your Bible, and then get, what am I missing? Your rag, okay? It's time to pray. Set your time on your timer. Somebody forgot about the timer. Get your timers ready. Those of us who have been hurt and abused, listen to me. I want you to pray. Deliver yourself from those who have abused you. Deliver yourself. Come on, deliver yourself. Clap those hands. Stamp your feet. Begin to walk around that house like you own it. Begin to walk, listen, begin to walk around that house. Let the devil know that you pay those bills in there. All the groceries are being paid for by you. So listen to me. Begin to walk around in the name of Jesus, Father God. Those of us, Father, who have been hurt. Those of us, Father God, who have been taken advantage of. Father, we come this morning, not in any other's, not in anybody's name, but the name of Jesus. And Father, we come to ask you, Father God, to remember us this morning. Because Father God, we cannot allow what has been done to us, Father, to prevent us from going to the next level. We cannot allow what has been done to us to prevent us from touching heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus, we will not miss out on our destiny. Because Father God, we know that whatever it is that we've been through, Father, it was to process us. It was to, Father God, process us. Father, you needed to process us. And for some of us, God, you are still processing us. In the mighty name of Jesus. So God, we're asking you this morning that Father God, you will finish this process, God. Father, we will not complain any longer. Father, we will not complain any longer. We will pass through this test. We will pass through this test. Father, those who are sick, those who are vulnerable, Father, those who have ailments in their body, sickness is ravaging them. In the name of Jesus, Father, we command the heavens to open up for them, God. Let them receive a touch of the Holy Ghost. Let them receive a touch of the Holy Ghost. Let them receive a touch of the Holy Ghost. Let them receive a touch of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus, angels bow before you, God. Heaven and earth adore you in the mighty name of Jesus. So, Father, we serve a living God. We serve a wonderful God. We serve a God of miracles. We serve a God who is able to heal. We serve a God who is able to deliver this morning, this hour, this afternoon, this evening, Father God, at this midnight hour. Father, somebody is in the midnight season in the realms of the spirit, and Father, if they are not delivered and if they are not set free, the enemy will take over their lives, the enemy will take over their house, the enemy wants to inject sickness into their homes, the enemy wants to inject sickness into their body. But this morning, Father, we stand as the army of the living God, and we pray in the mighty name of Jesus that sickness will not be their portion, that failure will not be their portion, that the power of wickedness will not prevail in their homes. Father, if the kingdom of heaven can be established, if Jesus can build his church, then we know that devil has no power, then we know that hell has no authority, then we know that the principalities have no power in the mighty name of Jesus. That is why we're coming to you, because we know that you are more than able in the name of Jesus. We know that you are more than able in the mighty name of Jesus. We know that you are more than able in the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody stop for a second. Drink some water. Have a sip of some water. Those of you who are thirsty, wipe your brow. Ha! Yes, Lord. People, listen to me. Do me a favor. Make sure you're registering for a call to prayer and get you some people who don't know how to pray. I'm telling you, where your brother is in this season, listen to me. Listen, where your brother is getting to in this season, all I'm asking you is to pray for me and just support me like you do. Okay, so all I'm asking you to do, just pray. Listen, I told you something a few seconds ago, and the Lord is still ministering to me about it. Listen to me. See, my God, listen, some of you, listen to me, you're making a mistake. You keep rejecting the trial and the test when it comes your way. Listen to me. You keep rejecting the trial. Listen to me. Listen. See. Listen. Palalabasia. Belileba. Sipe. Fasoto. Leprosikelelebasia. Laprasike. My God, I feel it. He's trying to give me something, and you know, I'm a little bit slow sometimes. I'm trying to receive it, trying to see how I should interpret. Listen to me. Listen to what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Listen. God wants to save you some money in this season. You know why he wants to save you some money? See, a lot of, do you know, listen, do you know how much money companies and corporations spend on advertising in a year? Do your research and you will see how much money major companies spend in a year advertising. And listen to me, the Lord is saying in this season, listen to me, I don't want you to have a budget for advertising. You know why? Because I want those who are against you, those, listen to me, those who feel like you will not amount to nothing, I want them to become your advertisers. You know why I want them to become your advertisers? Because it's free. They will talk about you and you don't need to pay them. They will talk about you and you don't need to pay them. Brother Keith, you don't need to pay them. You don't need to pay them. Do you understand? You don't need to pay them. All you need to, listen, you know them, you know those people who beat Jesus, you know, whipped him on his back, you know, spat in his face. They, listen to me, had they not done that to Jesus, watch this now, his fame and the record books will not have been written. Because listen, even those who did not believe in him, watch this now, when they stood there and they saw, how is it possible that another human being, watch this now, will look at another human being and spit in his face? Somebody, watch this now, who everything that they were talking about concerning him was a rumor. There was no facts to back up what they were saying. Because listen to me, God needed the whole of humanity to pause for a minute and see what was being done to this young man. Now listen to me, some of you I know, because of Facebook Live. Listen, somebody has spoken negative about you. Somebody has talked about you, and it's on Facebook Live, and it's on Twitter, and it's on Instagram. And listen to me, you are wasting your time trying to write to, you know, Twitter and all these people to get rid of that stuff. But listen to me, the Lord said, listen, ha, basha, I'm using them to advertise you. I'm using them to advertise you. Because listen to me, when you finally rise up from that pit, those who've read the negatives will look at the negatives and will look at you and say, listen to me, this person, sister so-and-so, doesn't match up to what is being said about her. Do you know, listen, do you know what is going to sustain you in this season? Is what I've given you. Your towel, your Bible, your water, and your timer. When you're in your house all by yourself and you feel lost and you feel alone, grab a hold of those four things. Find you a corner. Cry unto him. When the tears come, don't wipe it. Let the tears roll off your eyes. Listen, let the tears roll off your face and call upon him. My God, nobody can help you but Jesus. Nobody can comfort you but Jesus. So listen to me, you need to keep your eyes on him, because he's able. Yesterday I passed the test. I told you, remember I told you a couple of weeks ago that, you know, I can be a little bit of a hothead, you know, like, you know, I can get, and it was so amazing yesterday. I was the calmer one. Oh, I was so calm. I knew that Jesus has been doing a work on the inside of me. Oh, I know that Jesus has saved me for real. Oh, he was with me. I'm telling you, I said he was with me. So listen to me, saints. Saints, children of the Most High God, Prayer Mantle family. As you know what this house and this ministry is about, I keep telling you, if you know that there is something in your life that you know this thing is an issue, please handle it. Hand it over to him. Say, God, this part of my life, I'm not pleased with what I'm doing. This part of my life, I'm not pleased with what I'm doing. Please help me. Touch me. Touch me. Help me. Get rid of this thing before it comes and consumes me. My God, you know the most, listen, this is perhaps the most powerful revelation the Lord has ever given me concerning the blood. God needed somebody to spill the blood of his son. And listen to me, God could not allow his son, what is to self-mutilate, because that is not part of his agenda. You know, that is not the will of God concerning his children. See, he wouldn't allow, because what is now, my God. So listen, if Jesus self-mutilates and the blood comes, then what is now, he will be like the prophets of Baal. You know the story of the prophets of Baal. When Elijah got into a battle with them, the Bible says that, you know, they began to, you know, cut themselves. You remember that story? You remember that? Listen, you've tapped into prayer this morning, because what is now, the prophets of Baal, in order to call upon their God, they began to cut themselves. They began to cut themselves. So God could not allow his son to be like them. So God allowed, because listen to me, ultimately the blood had to be shed. He said, since you are against my son, I'm going to allow the prince of darkness to come into you, so that you will pierce him. And when you pierce him, my God, and when the blood mixes with the earth, My God, because what you don't know is in the beginning, see, when I was formulating my son, when I was forming Adam, you know, I was doing some mixtures that you're not privy to. But I want to show the people in the 21st century how I came about forming my son. So I'm going to allow the water and the blood to mix with the dust, the earth. And when that happens, he's going to give up the ghost because he has completed his assignment. And he's going to say, it is finished. Listen to me, brother, sister. Listen to me. I'm a living testimony. Trust me, those of you who know me, the thing that I've been through in church, the things that preachers have done to me, the things that so-called men of God have done, the things that so-called prophets have done, if I'm to sit down and think about those things, trust me, I'd have given up on Christ a long time ago. I'd probably be in jail because there's definitely one person that I'd have killed. I'm being serious. Definitely one person I would have killed. But God. God has been working on me and is still working on me. But I've gone crazy. Lost my mind. But God. You know, we don't like to tell the truth, you know, these days. I'm telling you. People got scared for me. People were nervous because of the things that was going through my mind just in the last year and a half. The things that was going through my mind and the things that I knew I could do. But God. Give him a big G, okay? We don't serve the small G. We serve the big G, G-O-D. But God. But God. You see this ministry? Do you see why I had to go through all of those things? Because listen to me, God had to take me through to let you see that it is possible. It is possible. It is possible. You don't have to lose your mind. You don't have to. I know it's painful. I cried. Some of you saw me on Periscope last year. The year before. Coming on Periscope, and I'll turn the camera around because I didn't want anybody to see me crying. But God, I said, but God, He's a keeper. He will keep you. I had a preacher said, only if you want to be kept. I love that preacher so much. He said, He will keep you only if you want to be kept. I know it's painful. I've been there. Trust me. I've been there. You know why I climb the mountain every month? I made a promise to God. There's a vow that I've made to God. Say, God, I hand over my life to you. He's the God of all flesh. Prayer Mantle, I'm telling you. You're going to see the evidence, Dr. Nikisha. You're going to see the evidence in July. Listen to me. Some of you don't even understand. The fact that you wake up every morning to pray, you're already victorious. Imagine if you didn't have prayer in your life and you were going through the thing that you're going through. How would you be able to cope? Pastor Charles. I've been so busy. I apologize. Okay, you know your brothers. You know I'm on a different. You know we have to make time to talk. We've just been all over the place. I'm telling you, but God. Sometimes I'll pick up the phone and I'll call some of you guys and I say, listen, what is going on? I don't understand. What is this? Look, today we have Australia. Look at me. Who am I? Young boy who grew up in Latabia Koshi here in Ghana. If I take you to the place that I grew up, okay, I came back to Ghana years ago, listen to me, and I just turned up at the place where I grew up. They looked at me shocked. How did you find it? I said, how can I miss this place when there's been no development for the last 30 years? The roads are still the same. The school that I went to is shut down. Ain't nothing changed here. Everything is still the same. Everything is still the same. I walk around. Listen to me. And I say, God, thank you that you even remember somebody like me. Thank you. Listen, I'm in Ghana. Somebody's in Australia. I don't even know the person. And the person comes on to pray with us every morning. And I don't even know what time zone, you know, what the time is in Australia right now. All of you all over the world. India, Brazil, Pakistan, praying. Imagine if I sat in my corner and I thought, you know what, I'm going to do something. Imagine if I thought too high of myself. Look at Australia, 9:34 p.m. I'm sure there's something on TV that you can watch, woman of God. I'm sure there's something you can watch on TV. Or you can even sleep or just go on your iPad and mess around. Why would you be listening to this boy with some strange accent? Oh, trust me, I don't think too highly of myself. I know. I know my limitation. I know I'm just a human being. You understand? And it is a pleasure to serve the living God. It is a pleasure to wake up to serve the living. I'm being serious. Because listen, I was in Jamaica. Was it Jamaica? I was with Prophet Khan. You know, this young boy who had his grandmother living in him. Grandmother had passed away. This young boy was 17, 18. Wasn't big, you know. Big men couldn't hold him down, disrupting the service. There I was thinking that, listen, I'm going to go cast this devil out. When I went into the room, the back office, they was praying for this young boy. Listen to me. His face was on the ground. When I walked into the room, he didn't see me. All he felt the door open. Listen, didn't see me. Didn't know I was coming. Guess what he said? I can't use the language that he used. But this is what he said. Who is this African who has come to, you know, like, cast this devil out of me? He said, who is this African? You know, and I laughed about it for, you know, Prophet Khan, we laugh about it. Listen to me. That young boy, who is this African? Mr. Farah. That young boy knew. Who is this African? I said, oh, so you know who I am? We spent hours praying for that boy. We still couldn't get all the demons out of him. So listen, prayer mantle, you know how we operate. I'm telling you, listen to me. If anything, Sister Renee, God is using this house, and I'm talking about you and me, okay, to let people understand that ministry has to be clean. We got too much mess on Facebook Live and Periscope. We got too many people coming on with the wrong motive and the wrong agenda. And listen, all they're interested in is coming to take money from people. And all they're interested in is raping people. And we have so many people who have become hurt because of what they've seen on Periscope and Facebook Live. God, where are you? Jesus, where are you? Father, your name is being used to rape your people. Please, God, don't sleep. Father, yes, Lord. Please, God, don't sleep. Don't sleep, God. Don't sleep on us. Don't sleep on us. We know that there are some of us that you have reserved. But Father, there are people out there misusing your name. Using your name to make money. Using your name, God. Help us. Help us, Holy Ghost. Help us. Hey! Help us. Help us. Help us. Help us, God, please. We need you. We need you. Those who are vulnerable. Those who are weak, those who are vulnerable, those who are weak, those who are being targeted. Please help. Help. Please help us. Listen, let that also be part of your prayer, okay? Please. Please let that be part of your prayer. Okay? Let that be part of your prayer. Pray for those who are vulnerable, who are weak, that, you know, pastors and preachers and prophets, okay, have kept in bondage. You know, like sometimes you hear on the news, you know, somebody who was chained up for years has just been, listen, let's pray that those that preachers are holding captive. The Bible says he came to set the captives free. Okay, he came to set the captives free. He came so that the captives can be set free. And the first group of captive people that he's coming for are those who are in the church. There are some people that preachers have told them that if you leave this church, you're going to die. If you leave this ministry, nothing will go well for you. If you leave this house, you're going to walk under a curse. So as much as they know that the place that they are is not a good place for them, they are scared. I'm being serious. I'm being serious. And I'm not just talking about, you know, Africa. I'm not just talking about Africa. There are people. There are people in America and the UK. They've been told by preachers. That if they leave, they're going to die. I'm being serious. It's all over the place. Because it's witchcraft that the person is operating in and under. So please, okay? When it comes to praying for the vulnerable, not just the sick, you know, in body, but there are people who are going to church every Sunday reluctantly. Because they've been told a curse has been issued. If you walk out of this church, nothing will go well for you. And you know, sometimes they will give you stories of somebody who left the church and died. Somebody who left the church and their business didn't go well. And it puts fear in people. So please. Okay? Bible says he came to set the captives free. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. God is all about giving you freedom. Look at that. Somebody says it's happening in Jamaica. It's happening everywhere. It's happening everywhere. You see, the greatest deliverance that you can have is a deliverance that will give you your freedom. Listen to me. The first deliverance that, listen, my God. Ho, yes, Lord. See, look at the book of Genesis in the beginning. God gave Adam and Eve, you can do whatever you want to do, just don't touch this tree. Freedom. Satan came, watches now, and put them in bondage. Remember that. The next time when man began to grow, okay, you see the people of God in Egypt, and they are in bondage, captivity. God comes and sets them free. That's what I'm saying. So listen to me, the enemy's assignment is to always keep you and I in bondage. That is why, listen to me, we have denominations. You know, this preacher don't talk to that preacher. This mega preacher doesn't talk to this other mega preacher. This other small church doesn't talk to this mega preacher. You know, there's arguments and fights because, listen to me now, the enemy knows that, listen, if I keep you, listen, you can have 10 different churches in the same area and none of the preachers talk to each other. You can have 10 churches in the same area. In the same area. And the preachers don't talk to each other. Look at the conferences that happens. Pay attention to the conferences. Pay attention. Look at the names. You know, you can see the cliques. When this person is having a conference, you will always see these people preaching for them. When this other person is having a conference, you will always see the same names praying for them. You never see this one preaching for this one. You've never seen this one, but we claim to be serving the same God. We claim every Sunday, serve the same God. But you've never seen this one get up and go to this other person's church. And this is what the world is looking at us, and they're trying to figure out what's wrong with these people. You know, a preacher, when they're having a conference, will go and fly a preacher from another continent, pay all kinds of money for them to come and preach to his people. When the preacher next door flows in the Holy Ghost, flows in the power, and can also equally pray, can equally preach. But guess what? I won't bring that person, because if my church folk find out that this one is good, they're going to leave me and go to that person. Do you know that's what's happening? That's what's happening. And you know, listen to me. Sometimes I don't blame, because you know, that's what happened. You know, prayer mantle, we went through that situation. Do you remember? You know the story? You know, somebody that we introduced, you know, all of a sudden, Sister Renee tried to come on Periscope at the same time and was feeding people junk. And the people said, hold on a minute. This young man was the one that introduced you to us. Now you want to come on at the same time as him? And you want to come and lie to us about him? Oh, no. We're not receiving that. You know what I'm talking about? So, see, this is what has also become an issue, Lady Anne. Lady Anne, did you just email me? I didn't block you. Do you understand? This is what the issue. So you know on both sides. On both sides. Sister Cheryl, I found out some more stuff. I was baffled. I was laughing. On both sides. See, when you're trying to do right, you're innocent. You know, like, what's, you know, come on. It's the same God that we're serving, right? But guess what? I found out that's not the same God. Just because somebody claimed to have a church don't mean they're serving. That's what the Bible says, that I will build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail against my church. The emphasis there is on that word, my church. You've seen, listen, prayer mantle, that's why, you know, I see everybody as family. You've seen me go through everything. You've seen me. Do you understand? Lady Anne, did you just message me? Something about blocking? You've seen me go through everything. Everything. But we're still standing. You see what I just told you? The Lord said, Albert, don't advertise yourself. I'm going to be the one that will allow people to advertise you. I'm going to be the one. Because the things that you've been through, and listen, you know the call to prayer. You know, we have almost 400 people. We're getting close to over 400 people registered for the call to prayer. Now listen, even if out of the 400, we get about 250 people coming, that is glory. That is glory. This African boy, just 7 people praying for people. Look at what the Lord can do when you trust him. You want to join? The call to prayer is in Charlotte. So, you might have to fly out. You might have to fly out to Charlotte if you can in July. Okay, please email us, okay? If you can, it'll be a pleasure to have you. Listen, this is what God does. This is what God does. So that's what I'm telling you. Listen to me. Don't ever think that God has left you. Don't ever think that he's not with you. He's always and will always be with us as long as we stay before his face. Thank you. Sorry. Listen, guess what I just did? I broke something in my house. Listen, you know when I received the revelation about the blood, I must have hit something. Look, a crack. Can you see it? Lord, help me. A crack. Lord, help me. A crack. I got too excited. I must have hit it. God help me. I must have hit it. Uh-oh. We love the Lord, okay? So listen, prayer mantle, thank you so much, okay? Please keep praying, okay? Keep praying and keep supporting, okay? Keep praying and keep supporting the ministry, okay? And if, you know people who are, you can tell that something is going wrong, pull them to the side and just have a nice word with them, okay? Don't judge them. Just pull them to the side, okay? Just have a conversation with them, okay? Pray for them, okay? God bless you. Sorry for taking too much of your time, but I really, really, really love you too, Brother George. Brother, you're in Brazil, right? Is it Brazil? That's our brother from Brazil, I believe. Look at that, all the way in Brazil. Isn't God wonderful? Chile. Only thing I know about Chile is football. Alexis Sanchez and Arturo Vidal. I love football. He will know what world. If you like, football, soccer. Yes, sir. Yeah, see, Vidal. But he missed a penalty yesterday. I don't know what's wrong with Vidal. He can be a little bit crazy sometimes. I know my soccer, After football, after the word of the Lord, I can talk to you about soccer. Yeah, Brother George is laughing. I was watching it, I don't know if they're going to go through now. I don't know, because, Real Madrid ain't playing. Ronaldo, they're going to go home, the second leg, so I don't know. Brother George, thank you so much, okay? Thank you so much. God bless you too, sir. I appreciate your support, and every single one of you. The brothers, thank you so much for supporting this ministry. Thank you so much. I appreciate every single one of you. Okay, I'm going to come on tonight. Listen, last night, I'm not going to lie, I just, the sleep got me. By the time I woke up, it was too late. So I apologize, okay? The sleep got me. Sister Renee, your son's team, what does he play? Email me or message me. Yeah, so I'm sorry, okay? But I'm grateful that there's two people, Sister Mary, praying all the time. So listen, soccer, is he good? Can he come and play for my team? Pray for you. Listen, this ministry is always praying. You don't even have to say it. There's people praying for you on that mountaintop. The prayer wall is up there, okay? So listen, when you feel down, listen, one of the things that you can use to defeat the enemy is to know within yourself that even though you're going through what you're going through, there are people praying for you, even when you can't pray. Just know that. And tell the devil, say, listen, you can't get me. Even though you try to shut my mouth, there's people. I got my brother in Africa praying for me. Be serious. Just say that. Say, listen, my brother Albert is praying for me. So I know you can't get me. Even though I can't pray, my brother is praying for me. Just say that to the devil. Say, listen, brother Albert is praying for me. So I don't know what you're trying to do to me. Yes, son. That in itself is a type of victory. Be serious. It is a type of victory. Listen, devil, I know you try to shout, but brother Albert is praying for me. When he starts praying, you ain't got no chance with me. And just walk on. You have to let the devil know who you are, that you know who you are. When the devil came against Jesus, said, listen, it is written. Okay, now, what else do you have? It is written. Listen, I've got brother Albert praying for me. I pray all the time myself, but listen to me. Because today I'm down, Brother Albert is praying for me. So you know what? Just go find yourself somewhere and park yourself. The devil, leave me alone. Listen, that alone, it doesn't mean that the trouble or whatever it is that you're facing will go away instantly. You see what I'm saying? But it's letting the devil know that the devil doesn't have your attention. See, when the devil came to Jesus, Jesus made the devil know, you don't have my attention. I see what you're bringing, but it is written. Let's say I got some brother in Ghana. He's praying for me. That's what he does. He just prays. So please, just go park yourself somewhere. I don't know if you say that in, like your language. Go and park yourself somewhere. Go find somewhere to sit down. Sit down. Sit down somewhere. Okay? In Jesus' name. God bless you. See, like Dr. Dana, it takes time. Sometimes it will take time for the healing to, it's a process. And God is working it. And now you're seeing the change. So what you need to do now is to intensify your praying. Pray some more. If you pray for 5 minutes, pray for 10 minutes. Pray for 15 minutes. Listen, by the time we finish, right, you realize that you can stand for an hour and pray, and you will not feel that you've prayed for an hour. Some of you could barely pray for 2 minutes. Now you pray for 7 minutes nonstop. You're like, oh my goodness, I pray for 7 minutes? Been in church all my life. Wow, I can pray for, I didn't know that. That's how it is. Talk to the hand. Jesus, I ain't got time for, just talk to the hand. way before that thing became, you know, like talk. Jesus had talked to the hand. I ain't got time for you. It is written. How about that? It is written. Ah, I think Jesus was African. He said, it is written. It is written. Yachou book ni muse. Man shall not live by bread alone. It is written in that will that he will give his angels charge over me. What are you talking? Where are you from? Don't you know me? I was there. Before in the beginning, I was there. You understand? Before in the beginning, I was there. I was there when they threw you out of heaven. So one day you think you can come and tempt me with material things that I created. How about them? You are crazy. How about them? I was there. Have you ever been in a position where, like, let's say somebody stole something from you and then they tried to, you know, they came back to sell it to you, the very thing that they stole from you? Somebody stole something from you, right? And then they came back, they didn't even know that it was you that they stole from, and they came back to sell it to you. Jesus said, Charlie Bunsama Bodampa. These things that you're trying to give to me, you stole it. You used deception to get your hands on it. That's why you say it has been given. It wasn't given to you. You stole it. You used deception to get your hands on it. And now you're coming to, listen. The thing that was given to you, the person that you stole it from, go and ask him where he got it from. That's my African coming out. Tio, I don't know if there's a Ghanaian on here. Adiana Uviayano. Listen to what I'm saying. You not understand it, but let me express myself. Adiana Uviayano. Kobusani pana uye free ni honom ne se. Ono no hwanane de ma no. Listen to what I just said, though. I just said, the thing that you are showing me that you're going to give to me, okay? Go, are you Ghanaian? The one that's laughing. Go and ask the person that you stole it from. Listen, ask that person. My English, I can't express like how I want to. Go, listen. Ah, sister. Kwachia ni se, onko busani pana uvia adiani fui ni hone se, hwana ne de ma no. Jesus said, go and ask the devil. See that thing. Who gave it to you? Who gave it to them for you to even have the opportunity to steal it? You are coming to show me something that I created and I gave to Adam. And you stole it from Adam. And you are coming to tell me, say, you will give it to me. When the thing, Jesus help me. Lord Jesus. Let me stop. Listen, when God begins to talk to you, see, that's why, listen, you have to get excited. You know what I'm saying? Sister Trish, you have to get excited. You understand? That thing that the devil is trying, listen, that thing that you think, you don't think you can get your hands on, it belongs to you anyway. It belongs to you. Stop putting your eyes on those things and look to God. Listen, it is written. It is yours. It is written. It belongs to you. You know why it belongs to you? Because it belongs to your father. And your father has willed it. You see, he has willed it in this book. And listen, if he was living, you couldn't get your hands on it. But listen to me, because he wanted you to have it, that is why he went on the cross to die. So then listen to me, if you find yourself in this book, there is absolutely nothing that you can't get your hands on. Stop chasing these jokers and these fake people who now masquerade as prophets. A bunch of fakes and a bunch of liars. Find yourself in this book. Every day, read a chapter. The more you read, the more you begin to understand what belongs to you. The more you begin to know what is rightfully yours. Imagine if your father owns the Hilton, you know, the whole Hilton Corporation, and you don't know that belongs to your father. Listen to me. If you don't know, your father will die and somebody else will come and chop the money. That's what the African will say. They will come and chop the money because you don't even know what is rightfully yours. And you are walking around slaving yourself when you're supposed to live. Listen, Solomon said, I have seen servants on horses and princes walking barefoot. Sorry, I'm keeping you. Listen, I have seen, Solomon said, I have seen something that is illegal on this earth. He said, I have seen servants on horses and princes walking barefoot. Listen to me. Not only has the prince been dismounted from the horse that you are supposed to be sitting on, you are now also walking. That means the shoes that you was wearing, the servant has taken the shoes off your feet and you are now walking bare feet. Should I stop? I don't want nobody to get upset with me. I need to stop. I've taken too much of your time. I apologize. Mr. Farrar, I apologize. I don't want nobody to be late to work. I'm telling you, got to get to that place where you know who you are. I have seen servants on horses and princes walking barefoot. Princesses walking barefoot. You are supposed to have people who are working for you. But listen, today the people that are supposed to be working for you, you are rather working for them and they are paying you a wage and a salary. That is why they are mistreating you. Because listen to me, they need to destroy, they need to break you down. Because the day that you realize, I will arise and go to my father. Because even in my father's house are many mansions. Even in my father's house there are servants. When I was with my father, I had people who will fetch water for me to bath. I had people who will make my food. Today I am living with pigs and I am eating the food of pigs. I'm going to arise and I'm going to go back to my daddy's house. If I could just find myself back in my daddy's house, everything will go back to normal. Find yourself back in your daddy's house. Stop chasing that joker, brother, sister. Stop chasing that joker. That joker ain't gonna do nothing for you. You know that. What are you chasing them for? Let's pray. Let me go. I've messed up. I was trying to do 7 minutes. I was doing well the last couple of days, but I messed up today. Bow your heads. Let's pray. Let me get out of the way. Father, we thank you for this morning. You are God. There's none like you. Blessings and glory, wisdom, thanksgiving, power and might belongs to you forever and ever. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless your name. Thank you for this family. It's the best family in the whole wide world. Sorry, excuse me. Father, we thank you for what you've done and for what you're doing. Bless us. Favor us. Show us the way to go. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be praised. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you, prayer mantle. Listen, I managed to get the information from Sister Keondra about the hotel for those of you who were asking for a call to prayer, okay? So Sister Mary is going to be sending out information, I believe, going to send out information very soon. Okay? God bless you. My sister, that's Ghanaian. God bless you. I think, Sister Purity, I don't think she's on today. But God bless you, okay? God bless you all. I see you tonight. Pray that I'll sleep early so I can wake up. Okay? I feel good. I thought a yoke on me, but he broke it. Just keep on praying for me, okay? And please, okay? You remember we got this month, we got next month, we April, May, and June. Please, just put something together and give it as your, contribution for the cost of a call to prayer, okay? You know how we operate. We're just transparent. I don't do them kind of stuff, bunch of whole lies going on in this thing. God bless us. God bless you, okay? I see you tonight. Thank you so much. I feel good. Somebody pushed me through. I feel good. I was a little bit, the devil was trying to get me. I'm being serious. The devil was trying to get me last night, this morning, but I came on and something broke. I feel good. Dr. Nikisha, stay there. Trust me. You ain't seen nothing yet. I don't care how bad it gets. And listen, I'm not going to babysit you, Dr. Nikisha. Listen to me. You got to toughen up. Bobby, you got to toughen up. You got to be tough. You got to stand in face and say, devil, listen, get out of my house. I'm telling you. Listen, I don't come and tell people it's going to be all right. Oh, Jesus said it. Listen, to be strong, I have to make sure that you are tough. When the enemy comes in like a flood, that's how the enemy is going to come in. You see what I'm saying? I ain't going to listen. It's going to get worse. Do you see what is happening? You see the confusion with, you know, Putin and Donald Trump? You see what is happening in Syria? You see North Korea? North Korea talking about they're going to test some nuclear weapons. You see what is going on the news? You have your preachers telling you everything is going to be okay. The devil is a liar. It's not going to be okay. It's going to get worse. You got all them bunch of crazy people in power right now. Have you seen that? You got a whole bunch of people who are crazy right now in power. Nobody backs down. Nobody's backing down. Talk about it's going to get better. You need to make sure you have a prayer life. In Jesus' name. God bless you, okay? I'll see you tonight, okay? Come on, come on, let's pray. Okay, love you. See you tonight. God bless you. Bye-bye. My sister in Australia, God bless you. You're covered in Jesus' name. Lady Anne, did you say that I blocked you? Was it you? I think I saw something like that. Better be prepared to come to Ghana. Lady Anne, you're not responding to me. Did you say I blocked you? Or was it by mistake? God bless you, every single one of you. You know prayer mantle loves you. That's why I tell you the truth. Lady Anne, where you at? Respond to me so I can leave. But I didn't block you, but you're back on. Or did your periscope cut off or something? God bless you. Everything, children, house, everything that belongs to us is blessed. In Jesus' name. God bless you. I'll see you tonight, okay? Oh, somebody did, not me. God bless you. Bye-bye.